There's easy methods to living a healthy lifestyle. She's shared her expertise with us here on air before, and today she's back from Texas. That's right. She's back from Texas here to discuss the second edition of her book, How to Be a Healthy Vegetarian. Please welcome back author, chef, and health and nutrition expert, Nancy Addison. And good morning.
Good morning.
I almost got stuck there. I was like, I was going to say Austin, but I don't necessarily know if it's Austin. I know it's Texas.
I'm from Dallas.
Dallas, yeah. I was like, all right, so I'm good. I'm glad I said Texas, even though I gave myself up. And then, just in case you were wondering what my thought process was in that moment. But welcome back, and thank you for visiting us here again during your visits to New York.
Thank you. I always enjoy seeing you and talking to you about the nutrition and how to have everyone have more optimum health.
And I do want to say I'd like to thank you and personally acknowledge this book, Lose Weight and Get Healthy, right? Because she gave me a copy, and I've actually been using it as a reference, and it's a great reference because it isn't a book for diets. It's kind of a book for every day that you can kind of just use as a reminder of just little things that will actually make a difference. And I would like to say, since I last saw you, I do you think I dropped a little bit here?
I think you look wonderful. Yes, you're looking healthier and healthier every day.
Good. You're not just saying that, right?
Right.
Okay. Well, also the water intake plays a role because that's one of the things that you mentioned in this book is how you can actually supplement meals with water and how sometimes your body's really asking for the water and also now to drink water while you're eating.
Yes, absolutely, because that, you know, waters down your digestive enzymes and you're not able to digest your food properly. And so you should wait about 2 hours after a meal and then drink your water. And a lot of times we have cravings for food and we think we're hungry, but yet we're really craving hydration.
And so how many books do you have now?
I have five out right now.
You have five books. I'm just out of curiosity, what inspired you to actually pursue this field?
Well, I grew up in Texas on a very meat, fried food, barbecue-based diet, and most of the people in my family were having heart attacks and strokes and dying of cancer, and I started looking at the nutrition aspect of all these things and how you can prevent that, and what I found was the plant-based diet can really actually help prevent heart disease, diabetes, cancer, and even Dr. Esselstein at the Cleveland Heart Clinic has proven through years of working with a plant-based diet that it can actually reverse the effects of a heart disease.
So when you say plant-based diet, are you referring to being a vegetarian, or is that just an incorporation into your diet?
Well, I mean, I really think the plant-based foods are what heal the body. And when you learn to add more of those to your diet, it really benefits your health. I'm not saying everyone should be 100% vegetarian. I happen to be, and that works for me, and I teach people how to do that. But if you're adding more plant-based foods to your diet on a regular basis, then your health is really going to benefit from that.
So in your writing of How to Be a Healthy Vegetarian, are you teaching people, because this is a new book, I don't have this one yet, everybody, just so you know, this is the first time I'm seeing it as well. Do you teach people how to prepare it, right? Because one of the things about living that lifestyle is like, oh, you gotta eat greens, it tastes the same, we gotta mix up the flavor. I mean, you know, I'm a Latina, so I gotta flavor it up, and there's always garlic and everything just to make sure it has that sabor, you know?
Yes, yes. No, I do teach people. Half of the book is recipes, so it's really a healthy cookbook, and it helps you put it in practice. And so I teach people how to add, like, mushrooms that are high in protein and they have less calories than, say, meat does. And you can substitute chopped and sliced mushrooms instead of meat in some recipes. And it still has that meaty flavor and it has all the richness. But you're talking about garlic and onions. I do teach people how to use more nutrient-dense foods because when you're getting those important nutrients, your body gets satisfied and you find that you eat less. And it can still be delicious.
Right. You know, what we call garlic, so onions, and peppers is sofrito. That's what we call it, just so you know. You learn something. Maybe you know, but that's what we do. We do it all in one batch, and then we freeze it, and then we put that on everything and make it taste good.
I think that's great. And those foods actually have natural probiotics in it, so it supports your immune system.
Yay.
Which is awesome.
We got a plus in that area, because, you know, I got to tell you, within my community, there's a big issue regarding diabetes, high blood pressure, and obesity, and heart condition. And it has to do with the combination of foods. And so I, myself, advocating health and wellness without, like, basically saying, oh, we can only be vegetarians, is I've been trying to figure out a way to kind of lead everybody or guide everybody in the direction of just being conscious of it. And so I really appreciate this book that you gave me. Simple things such as the water. I mean, just the simple things. Like, even for example, I was sharing with you before we got on air, my nutritionist had me work with an app that actually provides me with the caloric counts of the ingredients, which also plays a role. Let's talk a little bit about that.
Absolutely. Most of the foods grown in the United States are grown with chemical fertilizers and pesticides. So what that does is it prevents the food from having essential nutrients in it that we need. One of those in particular, you were mentioning diabetes, is having chromium in your diet. And chromium is an essential nutrient you need to take the sugar, the glucose, from the bloodstream into the muscle. And I believe that's missing from most people's diet. And if you can supplement with the right type of chromium, that's important. It should always say GTF on it. Glucose tolerance factor, GTF, on the chromium, which means it's not synthetic and it will actually really work well in your body. And you always want to make sure that your supplements don't
have... I think I'm going to write that down, because...
Yes, that is...
GTF, you said.
Absolutely. That is what to look for in your chromium supplement. And I put things like this in my book, which really makes it important. Also, if magnesium sulfate is in any of your supplements, it makes them pretty much useless. So you want to make sure that it doesn't have any magnesium sulfate in it, because otherwise that they use it as a cheap filler in some things. Mm-hmm. So quality is important. And knowing the right types of supplements, I think, are important, because, you know, you don't want to throw your money away on things that really are not going to work.
So just putting myself out there saying, listen, I had gestational diabetes when I was pregnant. I am no longer diagnosed with it. Thank God. However, I understand now that I may have somewhat of an insulin resistance, right? Which is kind of like something I need to work on and make sure I pay attention to it, because if not, I may end up back where I was. And I don't even want to say it because I don't want to bring it into my space. However, just these little notes here. And let's just say somebody who may be listening, who may be diagnosed pre-diabetes, what would you recommend that they do? Would you recommend, just honestly, that they just become straight vegetarians?
Well, it actually is the best way to reverse that and to heal the body, and especially with whole, real food. And I think really avoiding processed foods is really important. A lot of times they add fructose to that, which can lower your insulin resistance. And all of these like high fructose corn syrups and purified things that they refined flours and sugars, I think leaving those out of the diet. So I really propose eating healthier foods, and things like cucumber actually have a hormone in it that can help the pancreas produce more insulin. So just knowing little things like that, you know, maybe use cucumber slices with your hummus instead of crackers or something like that, can be incredibly valuable to your diet. And avoiding the white refined breads and flours and using whole sprouted grains. And I teach people how to prepare all of these very easily and simply. And also it can be very cost effective to do a vegetarian, healthy vegetarian diet.
Well, thank you. Thank you for always giving me that one tip. You gave me a tip. I'm circling it. I'm like, oh, I'm taking that one today. And I thank you for always making sure you stop by our studios and share your knowledge with us. And, of course, this book is available online.
Yes.
At Amazon and on your website, right?
Yes.
How to Be a Healthy Vegetarian. And once again, for more on Nancy and her wealth of knowledge, you can visit her website by going to organichealthylifestyle.com.